गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, लेट अस नेक्स्ट सी द प्रॉब्लम सेट 6. चूज द करेक्ट ऑल्टरनेटिव एंड फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स. रेडियस ऑफ द सर्कल इज 10 सेंटीमीटर्स एंड डिस्टेंस ऑफ द कॉर्ड फ्रॉम द सेंटर इज 6 सेंटीमीटर. फाइंड द लेंथ ऑफ द कॉर्ड. सो हियर यू अप्लाई द पाइथागोरस थ्योरम टू द सर्कल, टू द ट्रायंगल इन द सर्कल. And then you find out the answer. Answer you will get is 16 centimeters. The point of concurrence of all angle bisectors of the triangle is called as the incenter. The circle which passes through all the vertices of a triangle is called circumcircle. The length of the chord of the circle is 24 centimeters. If the distance of the chord from the center is 5 centimeter, then the radius of that circle is 13 centimeters. Then the length of the longest chord of the circle with radius 2.9 centimeters is 2.9 into 2, that is 5.8 centimeters. All of you know that diameter is the longest chord of the circle. Then radius of the circle with center O is 6 centimeter. If OP equal to 64.2 centimeter, say where the point P lie. Point P lies outside the circle. The lengths of the parallel chords which are on opposite sides of the center of the circle are 6 centimeter and 8 centimeters. If the radius of the circle is 5 centimeter, then the distance between these chords is 7 centimeters. This you have to solve and show it. So sums of this step you have done earlier. Then the fourth sum you see in the figure, C is the center of the circle, QT is the diameter, CT equal to 13, and find
definite integral.
Find RS. Now draw CR. CT equal to CR is equal to 13, radius of the circle. CP equal to 5. In right angled triangle RPC, CR square is equal to CP square plus RP square, Pythagoras theorem. 13 square is equal to 5 square plus RP square. So RP square will be equal to 13 square minus 5 square, that is 169 minus 25, that is 144. So RP is equal to 12. So RP is equal to half of RS. So RS will be equal to 2 into 12, that is 24 units. Then in the figure, P is the center of the circle. Chord AB and chord CD intersect on diameter at point P. Angle AEP is congruent to angle DEP to prove that AB is equal to CD. Now given the circle with center P. Angle AEP is congruent to angle DEP to prove that segment AB is congruent to segment CD. Now draw PN perpendicular to segment DC. Draw segment PM perpendicular to segment AB in triangle NEP and triangle MEP. Angle AEP is congruent to angle DEP given. So angle PNE is congruent to angle PME. Segment EP is congruent to segment EP. So therefore triangle NEP is congruent to triangle MEP by AA test, SAA test. So PN is congruent to PM, corresponding sides of congruent triangles. Now chord CD is congruent to chord AB. Chords of the circle equidistant from the center are congruent. Now sixth sum given, segment CD is perpendicular to segment AB. Segment CD is the diameter of the circle with center O to prove that triangle ABC is isosceles triangle. Now diameter CD of the circle is perpendicular to chord AB at point E. Therefore OE is perpendicular to AB. So in triangle ACD and triangle BCE, segment AE is congruent to segment BE. Angle CEA is congruent to angle CEB. segment CD is congruent to segment CD. So therefore, triangle CDEA is congruent to triangle CDB by SAS test. So segment CA is congruent to segment CB. So triangle ABC is isosceles.